la tumor con el protoplasma hasta salir. And then other than that, just limited to the ear surface. Some of them are limited just to the white matter, those are the virus astrocytes. And one more intense thing is that sanctuals and sickle cell were surrounded just one blood vessel, well, specifically. So those four types of astrocytes are related to me, it's related to the open view. Then we also make some analysis how those astrocytes are divided. And we saw that when they arrive to the target area, and in that area, they begin to divide select and form a close of astrocytes altogether. This is really different to the way that the neuron are said that. Next. So, in that way, while we did injection into the very personal part of the factor of the lateral vertebra, the back and vertebra, we were able to trace the neural dispersion into the different astroglial areas. So here you can see like a very tiny injection in your optic vertebra, which is like a valid partial dispersion of all the astrocytes. There is a large diversity in those cones, and you can be doubting because maybe this is there is now under review, but it's a crazy way to count one by one of the other cells in the olfactory bag, and then to give a code of number of each cell. So it makes me join all the cells and we classify them close. We saw that there are many different astrocyte morphologies, but it was really interesting to see how one code is surrounding one domain, which is one domain, and also with different morphologies. One of those are inserted the processes into the factory development, and the other one are just surrounding the domain. So, we were asking if those clones could be referential public development. Why? Because some time ago in 2011, the group of Mr. Young explained that there was a preferential type of pesticide for the same domain. So, because we saw these images in clonal analysis, we thought that probably those will be serious. So now we are doing a collaboration with Christian Joe, in which, similar that the neural cell that are located in the same pattern, they are more connected, or the civil neural response is similar to visual stimuli. So probably the astrocyte, the clonal will be related astrocyte may act as a group, and when we inject, say for me that probably one of the astrocytes, we count what astrocytes are sibling, related, and what are not connected. So now our results look like they really are, there is a possible preference in the talking of sibling astrocytes through that just. So, Cajal was right, why? Because he described many kinds of astrocytes, and even he said that there was some isogenic groups of astrocytes that he called like twins astrocytes. So, now we have images, we see that we have right. But this means the extractor plane, you know, we just the morphology in a world section of the hemisphere. And we think that those isogenic groups that the family described are really the close that we are looking at in the system. So when we were looking at the specific disposition in the factory bag, we saw some big groups of cells, like this one, and we were wondering what are those cells. So if we look at the morphology of those cells, the structure labeled astrocyte is like this, while the structure labeled entity cell. So, we show that by the GFP promoter, we were able to label all the NP2 cells. We were studying the growth of those cells, and those were different to the cells because the corpus of the doctor, right? And they occupied, one cell occupied a very large distance from the western part of the doctor, right? To the north tower, right? This is about 1200 microns, the cloth. And this is really large, it dispersed throughout all the layers. And then the most important thing that we saw is that there is a progression of human size. And then there is characteristic of this exponential growth of the number of cells. So, in deep two body, those are injection into the protein, and in utero, and then we analyze a different natalitis. And at this age, there are close for about 500 cells. So we think that those cells are really important and probably are very related to the plasticity of the body because those cells have been in habitat. Also, another kind of structural application that is the analysis of chronic astrocyte response to cortical neurons. This work was made by the Martin Lopez, who now is postdoc at Yale University. After doing in vitro manipulation of the statical mix, we were able to calibrate, we made some bilateral visions, and to see how is the response, what is the global response of those astrocytes to the vision. So we were able to see that there are clones of astrocytes that they stay in a regular morphology, while others. By others, it has to be a hypertrophic portfolio. So we were thinking that there are some clones in single cell that respond to the single cell than other clones. And then, so far, we have like there is different lineage. One is the lineage mirror, that is, one in mirrors, predicted mirrors, are originated into the cortex, while the interneurons are coming from the ganglion nucleus or from the parietal cephalial part of the brain. And then, with our work, we have seen that if we first draw the line, we draw the line between the progenitor cell and the astrocyte, we see that there is different units. One could be those that have stimulized the parietal astrocyte. The other one will be the protoplasmic astrocyte, the fibrous astrocyte, and then the polydendrocyte or NBT cell. Those NBT cells have been so far saying that they are the progenitor of oligodendrocyte. So probably there is a part of those polydendrocyte that gives rise to different polydendrocyte types, and then another type of polydendrocyte that gives rise to other neurons. In fact, in my work has been done for time in vitro, but in vitro experiment, saying that some NBT cells give rise to neurons or astrocytes. So probably this will be related to the origin or the lineage of the disease. So we would like to know what is, if there is different time points and if there is B or T potential. For that, we have to develop a new method that is right now being published. It's the ubiquitous structure. With that, we can label all the images in the neuronal, the specific NBT2 and the neuroscience image. We will be using the image transposon and also. The problem that we have is that the non-integrated plasmid interferes in the chronic flow with cells that come from very few cells, like neuronal cells. So for that reason, we design different constructs to test different lineages, and then for the emission of non-integrated cortex, we use a clock system, and in that way we can silence those non-integrated plasmids. quieras tus votos, María Figueres, and then we can send the result. Now we can see many, many different types of things. We can say, we observe many neurons, clonal groups of neurons, astrocyte, oligodendrocyte, and even NDP cells. So we can see the interrelationship between the different units, and then to know that they have been labeled in detail at different levels. So, for example, in this image, we have a clone of neural cells. This clone of neural cells formed by a few number of cells. Normally, the clones of neural cells are very dispersed over the corpus of the factory body. We can see if there is interaction between those cells, those neural cells, and the cell astrocytes. We have been doing a work about the clonal dispersion of the embryonic incorporation in the factory body. We see this kind of image. This is an E13 computer injection at E13, and we observe how we are the different cells, like granule cell, with all the morphology. And there is an other way, this is more than 1 year. So there is no treatment of the cortex, so directly. Can see this kind of images in the different colors. This is another example. This is 7 months old, and the injection was at 15. And then here we can see how the disposition of the glomeruli and the interaction with different cells in the factory. We have other examples that are really beautiful to observe. No? And you see, if we are trying now to see if the colors have molecular sequence. So we can patch each of those cells belong to a clone, and you can see there a characteristic molecular expression. Another thing that we are very interested in the clonal dispersion of the clonal dispersion of the cytoplasm. This work is being done now with Arturo Valverde, and then we are able to follow in time lapse the different, the B, C, and C cell and the A neuroblast, and to see how those cells are divided. This is a E15 in utero injection, and then we have been observed this movie at E10. So we observe how the division in this case of this cell. And this is really interesting too. Because it's the first time that we see a neuroblast dividing when it's already a process, a long process like this one. If you see this cell, you can do a mitosis right here, and then this part of the pathway, and the other one is another process, is completed for what we have. So, throughout the roster method of the we can observe which kind of cell are sibling each other. So, this, for example, dots correspond to single cells that we are trying to do a clonal characterization of the RNAs and to see how they division into the RNAs. Those are another examples of the clonal dispersion into the factory body. That's when the cell arrives into the factory body. This is not an emergency, this is E2, and then observe in E22. And then we observe that there is a different perigomembran or granule cell in the factory one. So in that way, we were studying right now if there is any bipotential progenitor at the cerebellar zone area. And we have been studying the different one, the clones are really dispersed from the perigomembran into the factory one. But we observe that, for example, this clone is escorted by external glandular cells. So all of these cells belong to the same. In this one, the clone 3, number 3, there are mostly glandular cells located close to the epidermal area, but some of them are really far away from the epidermal area. going to be interested because half of the cell of the drug has the molecular cell, while the rest of the cell has the mirror located in the internal physical molecule. Here we have another example of different drugs that are located in different landings, so we have bipotential. So, my group is the, called the clonal, now we study the clonal analysis of neuroprotective cells in mice, and we have three different projects from different people in my lab. One is to know about the neural identity of neuroprotective cells, and we study that in the neurofactor environment, and also in the factors in the cerebral cortex, because many of the kids, and it's not easy to get into the factor drive, because you have to go to the very important part of the factor part. And then many of them are going to the cortex, so we are using that material for that. Because we are publishing now work on the cortex. And then we are working on the dispersal pattern of the different cell units, mainly in the factor part, in both embryonic and postnatal ages. And one of the main interests, very interest, the project now, the but injection in the uterine. So follow the lineage of the NDPBR and the symptoms have different type of year depending on the origin. So we have now some people in the United States looking at NDPBR cell from the symphalian part of the family part of the so I'm disabled and those the inside the recursive cell, and some others could be a kind of transformative cell. Anyway, my group now is covered by these people. This is Ana Vivian, that is a postdoctoral student that is working in the NDP project, with Rebecca, that is coming to the lab, doing the PhD, and Maria Figuera, that is finished the PhD. And it's working in the NDP system of the there is a people are student, but I'm going to be the lab. These are the three that have done most of the work and I'm excited today. And he's in the media farm in the University of Karolinska. And some people that is visiting the lab here in Karolinska now. In this level, we have many collaborations with different groups working in different systems. For example, this is Valentina for the group of Annalisa Rufo. In Italy, or the group of Arturo Alvarez Villa in San Francisco, in the group of Francisco Alvarez in Atlanta, working in so, thank you. We have been working on the micro cell development as a problem because it's not easy. Those are predicting neural some part of the factor, but and then it's not easy to label those cells because they need to be able to the so for that reason, we have been studying those specific flows and some of the interneurons incorporated at the bionic or different elements, but not the micro cell. No, we have learned the paralysis. For that reason, we feel that there is a homogeneous problem located in a specific place, namely the pockets. I mean, there is some that have already related to the field level. Some of them are close or by cells that are close to the field level. Another one about protoplastic cells, so that's related to also, I think that we can do like a ladder, you have depending on the body. You have a ladder, some astrocyte that are looking like an egg, throughout the process, and another in some cases. So I think that we can do like a ladder of astrocyte, depending on, based on the opportunity. No, not the same thing.